Dr. Celine Gounder, a member of the Biden-Harris Transition COVID-19 Advisory Board and infectious disease expert. Dr. Gounder, thank you so much for your time this morning. We appreciate it. I want to jump right to it here. When President-elect Joe Biden is inaugurated on January 20th, give us the top priorities, what you want to tackle immediately in fighting this virus that we're not seeing from the Trump administration right now.
Well, I think you're going to see the president-elect invoking the Defense Production Act. This will be an executive order to marshal resources, get manufacturers to produce the personal protective equipment, the masks, the face shields, the gloves that we have been pleading for months. We have been asking for President Trump to invoke the Defense Production Act for months. We've been functioning in this scarcity rationing phase for months. You know, me personally, when I've been caring for patients on the front lines at Bellevue, I've been using the same face shield since March. So this is really a critical need that needs to have been met really months ago, but will be finally met under the new administration.
Speaking of those critical needs that need to be met like immediately, President Trump has not accepted the results of this election, and the White House is blocking the transition of the Biden team. So how much of an impact is that having on your ability to hit the ground running, especially when it comes to the crucial task of distributing a vaccine?
Well, look, we're doing everything we can with the other partners that we can reach out to. That includes state and local health departments and public officials. That includes the private sector. But this, at the same time, is a national security threat. This is a national emergency. And the idea that you would not have collaborative handover of power in this context when national security, the health of the American people, and the economy are very much at stake is really quite shameful.
Do you think quickly that this delay in the transition could result in a delay of distributing the vaccine?
I certainly hope not. We are doing everything we can to ensure that's not the case, but there could be unforeseen consequences of this difficult handover.
Now, Biden has been vocal, as we know, in his support of mask mandates, but there is some question about his authority to do it on a national level. How do you plan to convince holdout governors and local leaders to get on board with masks, and can any of that be done before Biden takes office?
Well, I think I would remind the American people that this is something that is in their hands to control. We should each take personal responsibility for our health, the health of our families, the health of our communities. This is a great way to show that you appreciate the healthcare workers who've been making sacrifices for months now and still have months of true sacrifice ahead. This is a cheap, effective intervention that does not close the economy and that will, in fact, help us keep the economy open.
But just to follow up on that key part of the question, how do you convince the governors and those who don't want to get on board? How do you convince them to go along?
Well, we'll be reaching out to other allies who may have those kinds of relationships. But ultimately, you know, whether you have a mandate or not, I think the message here is this is a crisis and we each need to step up.
All right, Dr. Gounder, thank you so much for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.